Abby.
Say hi. Maybe I better do this. There we go. There we go.
Hi.
I'll use the little window.
Not so close.
Some Bobby. Here they go, Dad. See Rebecca?
Thank you.
stepping down from the Board of Education at the end of this month. She has served dutifully for the last 11 years, 10 years at the Board of Education. Prior to your success today is due to our dedicated staff. In addition to the high school teachers, we have a number of teachers from our middle school and elementary schools in attendance today. At this time, I'll take a moment just to have them stand and be recognized, and I'd like to have the students give an applause to the teachers in attendance today.
Aunts and uncles, neighbors and friends, distinguished platform guests, dedicated faculty, and certainly the very happy seniors of the class of 2005. I'd also like to welcome you to the historic Hill Auditorium, which has long been a symbol and a tradition of excellence and accomplishment. With every senior class, there is a special characteristic. For the class of 2005, they also had one. It's probably one of the most balanced classes that I have ever seen because they have been achieving in so many different areas. Sometimes there's a huge cluster in the academics, and then there's gaps in others. But it didn't matter what the area of study was, be it the academics, the visual and performing arts, athletics, culinary arts, community volunteering, and so many compliments have come forth to all of you from the work, from the employers that you have served, often stating to me, my wife and I were in Great Bar and Grill the other evening having dinner, and we have a couple of our students working there, and they came up to say how respectful they are, how dependent they are on your services, and what a good job you do. Also, I'd like to recognize the class of 2005 for their scholarship. 2 weeks ago, we had scholarship night. All the preceding classes have continued to break their records as far as total scholarships. Last year, the class of 2004 earned $1,650,000. This past September, the class of 2005 said, Mr. Couchman, we're going to break that record. And last, 2 weeks ago, we awarded to the class of 2005 $1,810,000.
Of course, like all underclassmen, we still have to drag ourselves up an entire flight of stairs every morning just to sophomore year taught us more about what we could handle and where we were going in life. Now Sarah Paulson, our class secretary, will speak on our junior year.
For most of us, junior year turned into a battle with an unexpected case of early senioritis. I watched in terror as one by one most of the class fell victim to this all too common affliction. We were already involved in sports, clubs, and jobs, and then we had to figure out what we should do with the rest of our lives. As if that weren't enough, they threw the ACT and the SAT at us. Junior year may not have been easy, but like our freshman and sophomore years, it helped define who we are and where we are going. Our junior year formed us into more capable individuals. And I want you all to remember, wherever we go, whatever we do, we are pirates.
I'd like to take this time to share with you all six all of you, 6 lessons that I have learned over my high school career. 1, sometimes you just have to say, eh, it happens. There are going to be many little annoyances throughout our lives. It's important.
Lauren Norris and Kimberly Wick. Let's give them a round of applause. Consecutive semesters of a 3.5 grade point average or higher are awarded a gold pin. These students are Gashawn Baber, yeah! Ian Boyle, Amy Deacon, Margaret Geierman, yeah! Michelle Cadon, Amber Kuzma, Matthew Lamoris, and Tracy Reed. What's most impressive is the students who have achieved 8 consecutive semesters of 3.5, and the list is quite long. We have a lot to be proud of with the class of 2005. These students are, please stand, Christopher Bishop, Allison Diaz, Annette Demon, Travis Dunny, Shannon Feeback, Erica Freiberg, Catherine Guyon, Megan Hamilton, Eleanor Hignight, Jessica Hitt, Brittany Jensen, Kelly King, Rebecca Cope, Brett Kosmicki, Ian Lind, Erica Linder, Ashley Lundy, Sarah Paulson, Chad Radlicki, Brandon Race, Allison Rose, Sarah Rouse, Maddie Leah Sammons, Andrea Smith, Meredith Stepien, Leah Tate, Melissa Thornton, Valerie Torrey, Kimberly Venta, and Abby Ventrone. Let's give them a round of applause. Achieve a 3.5 to a 3.79 grade point average all 4 years. This plaque will continue to hang at Pinckney Community High School with the names of these students in recognition of this academic achievement and remain a legacy in Pinckney Community High School. I wish my congratulations to all of these students. May you continue to fan the tiny, inner sparks of possibility into achievement. Well done.
Thank you, Dr. Scott. We'll now have the traditional claim of the alma mater.
Uh-oh. This thing just go boom bang. No?
Thank you.
like family.
The Roger Rabbit,
No matter what the future held, I knew I would never enter a high school, ever, ever again.
Teacher who shall remain nameless, you've learned that you can ponder to be or not to be while wearing any one of 75 outfits and matching shoes. You can coordinate your hair color with your ink preference. Ladies and gentlemen, accessorize.
From your fearless administrator, you have found that you can bench press the equivalent of the total weight that counts during any lunch while singing along to Les Mis, the Eagles, or other 70 love songs.
From the Media Center specialist, you have seen that with the same first and last name, you can be all about the business of books and technology, yet let your hair flow in the wind while riding your Harley to school.
Still be taken seriously while retelling a story you have of each body part using PowerPoint. Yes, we even included graphics and sound effects. You can love the man. Are you with me?
And from your mild-mannered math teacher, you have found that you can also be a stellar superhero and don the cape of Calculus Man.
Yes, indeed, throughout the years you have been taught repeatedly by these teachers and others what life will be like after graduation from high school. We know we have tried to bring in real-life scenarios into the classroom every day. However, we would be remiss if we failed to mention these last-minute guidelines that will promise to make your transition from Pinkney to the real world at large smooth and easy. Starting today, if you are ever in doubt, simply refer to this list. Chili dogs over cheeseburgers, onion rings over french fries, mustard over ketchup, mayo over Miracle Whip, malts over shake, Coke over Pepsi.
And on special occasions, Dr. Pepper.
Blue over green, deep dish over thin crust, angel hair over fettuccine, red sauce over white sauce, Family Guy over South Park, medium rare over medium well, Adidas over Nike.
Spanish over German. Sorry, Sebastian, you know I love you.
Dogs over cats, Jerry Springer Show, You're My Baby's Daddy, over Dr. Phil's Man, How to Get in Touch with Your Daddy. Ferrari over Lamborghini, Nestle Quick Syrup over the powder, Creamy Peanut Butter over Chunky, Feather Pillows over Sponge, Caddyshack over Happy Gilmore, West Coast over East Coast, Hawaii over the Caribbean, and finally, of course, White Castle over every other fast food.
Choices will assure you success in the world at large. You may or may not get the opportunity to choose with whom you live or how they will behave once you live with them, but you can choose how you behave. Therefore, we have compiled a mini presentation on common sense guidelines to sharing your space with someone else. Let's start with food, shall we? Maybe your family or friends have failed to properly inform you of that which is acceptable etiquette regarding food and food sharing. Warning, what you're about to see, especially from him, may shock you, but it's about to save your social life. Exhibit A. In a party environment, you may come across a community bowl of dip with several innocent chips waiting to be consumed. Relying on your Pinkney education, after the first bite, you're kicking it and ready to go in for the double dip. Hold it right there. This is a major no-no in the real world. Each chip necessitates just one dip. And if there's only one chip left, don't even think about taking that. That's just rude. Exhibit B, seemingly innocent, but behold our friend. Thereof, Drayback. This also includes Gatorade bottles, juice containers, and chocolate milk. If you really want to share your spit with the rest of the campus,
We have a list of other recommendations to see us after the ceremony. Now, from sharing food, let's talk about sharing the bathroom, where one false move can lead to untold hours of drama and unnecessary bickering. Are you a squeeze the middle or a squeeze the bottom type? Ah, yes, the toothpaste too. It can give you so much insight into others' personalities. If you're a fundamentalist like me, you probably squeeze from the bottom. You follow the directions on the back of the tube, and you enjoy a world of relative order. However, if you're a bottom squeezer who shares your space with a middle squeezer, I'm sorry to tell you, you've got just two options. Move out if you can, or if it's too late, just buy another tube and restore the peace. Are you thinking of going out for the night? Searching for that somebody special? What to wear? How are you going to pay? Two important distinctions must be made when sharing your possessions. Other people's property, the purse. Dang it, that's mine. Up until this point, most of you believe that it is perfectly acceptable to take any amount of funds from a parent's purse, wallet, or change jar. In the real world, this is a serious infraction. Not only will it damage the peace and inner sanctity of your relationship with that person, but it could also introduce serious doubts about your view. Outside the comfort of your own wardrobe in order to make a statement. Sometimes you're just tired of your own clothes. However, proper etiquette dictates that you ask permission and consider carefully the item in question. Even if they say yes, remember, what may look fabulous on them may be a totally inappropriate choice.
There are not that look good on me.
Okay. There are other secrets to making living with somebody a success, but we think these are things that you just should experience firsthand. We don't presume that you can learn everything from us in our short time together today.
After employing this knowledge on a daily basis,
thank you.
Education, pronounce you graduates of the class of 2005.
Should.